This is a tutorial for making game assets for Trains a New Era. I am working now on my Dutch tram route, and for this location I am going to make this building over here. For making the model I use Blender 2.9. If you want more information just for trains using FBX, just look on the wiki. I have put the link in the video description. For information about the material types, just look on the wiki. Here you can see the flats I was talking about when showing it in trains. From the street view images I have made this texture. We have the front texture, the roof, and one side. It was a lot of Photoshop work to remove some items from the front, but yeah, this is the best I can make of it. Now let's start making the flat. Of course this cube is way too small, this we need to measure the flat in Google Earth. Let's bring out the ruler. And this is a tram route, dus I only care about the front of the flat and the sides. The back side I do not care about. Flat is about this size. Let's put it in. First of all, let's show the keystrokes. Put it on the left so you can see which button I press. If I can the dimensions, it was yes. Let's put it in. Let's zoom out. Measure this. Now we have the top size. Now we're gonna look how high the building is. Of course I don't have the exact dimensions, so it's just guessing. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 layers. Let's assume it's 3 meters for one layer, dus you get 15 on the z-axis. Now we can see the grid is halfway, so that's not so good. Let's put it halfway on top of the grid. So you have to divide that total height by 2. Is 7.5 meters, and you can see the scale is not 1 anymore, and that can give a problem in trains, so we have to apply the scale. Control A, we have the apply menu, apply the scale, it's now 1. So this is the complete flat. Now we're gonna load some textures. We go to the material tab, because I have previously made some objects, or I already have made some basic material, and naming I have got it from the wiki for the material types. And if you scroll down, I use a very basic texture, just only one texture. So we take this one, m.1text, because I only use one texture, so we don't need have a very complex material. We can name it like this. Then we press use nodes. Then we press on base color on this yellow dot. Then we select image texture, then we select open and search for our texture. This is the folder where I store the texture. We select the texture, open image, and now this texture is loaded into the material. So the texture is loaded into the material. We can here press on the arrow to preview the image texture. And we can see it's shiny, and we don't want that. Just scroll down. The specular make it 0. And then is the texture just the texture and not shiny anymore. Then I have here on the left side, I have a second window. And we use that to unwrap the texture. Here in this window I press N to close this one, so that is more handleable. Now we have to unwrap the texture onto this box. Let's go into edit mode, press tab. On the left we can see our texture, and now go to face select on this button here, and we select this front face. And shift right select with the right mouse button to select. Now we have the front and the back selected. If you press 1, we come to front view. You press U and we do project from view. On the left side we have this little box, and this is the same as the view we got here. So we have to scale this up. Just S to scale. As you can see, we have only a gray box, so we have to press this button. Go to viewport shading, so we can see our texture. Now it looks very awful now, but we're gonna fix that with the UV mapping. We have this selected. If you press G to grab it, and you can see on the right side we have the windows. So we have to put this in the corner and adjust it to the texture. So this left corner is this left corner. If you zoom out, if you deselect, I'm selecting just the bottom line, and G for grab, and I press Y just to only move it in the Y direction. Put this on the bottom of the floor. Grab Y, now we can see the full height of the front. And now we have to put 9 sections for the whole flat. Just grab in the X direction, and now we have the count. 6, 7, 8, 9, almost 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. We have to move it to the left. Just about there. Now we can see why I make this texture this way. If one section here, and now I can tile the texture many times to left and right to make this incredible long apartment flat. So this is nice. We can deselect with the right mouse button. And here we have our front of the flat. Now let's do the sides. Selecting and shift right mouse button to select the other side. If you press number 3, we have the right view. Press U, project from view. Now we have this little box, and that's the side. As you can see, I have to put the side on an angle. Thus we have to rotate it. With this selected, I press R, move the mouse to the right, and enter 90, press enter, and now we have rotated 90 degrees. G for grab, and let's align this. Deselect it with the right mouse button and select it with the left. Grab Y, align it with the bottom side here. Grab X. Now you can see this aligns good on this side. And let's have a look on the other side. We have also the windows here. Now the bottom side of this model we don't need, dus we select it, press delete. We have the delete menu. We only want to delete the faces, so now it's deleted. Now we can select top, press number 7 to view the top. U, project from view. Now we have the top side. We have the same box over here. We have to align this. And in the texture I have two sections, so we have to be careful about that. So I can align this not on the left but on the middle of this. Let's align this. Because I have one half of a chimney, so it looks a little bit odd. Now we have to align this to this. It's quite difficult, so make this a little bit bigger. Let's have a look. I can see the chimney has to be on the middle of this wall. Let's have a look on the right side. Little bit more. Something about there. Just about there. Now we have the roof, the front and the back, and the left and the right. So we now have a super basic model. And that because it's a tram route, we only care about the front. So this is could be good enough. So we now have this simple model. If you look on the bottom side, it looks like the faces are double-sided. But if we go to the material properties, if we scroll down, have a look have a look at the settings and push this button, the back face culling, so we can see if the faces are real double-sided or not. So we can see this is only one-sided. So that is all good. Now we can save this model. I'm very lazy, this I just copy the name and I pass the name here. Save as. Now it's saved. We can see the top of the screen. It's saved as a blend file. Now we can have to export the file. It's file, export, and then we have FBX. And because I already have made some other models, I have made a preset and have called it Trains FBX Export. And now you can see all the settings here. I'll show you all the settings. These are all the FBX settings for trains. Very important for the scale to 1. And the rotation of the object is very, very important. Now we can export it by pressing the button. And now we have a look at the folder. Here we can see our folder with the blend file and the FBX file and the texture file. In this folder we have to add a config file for this just for trains. So just copy the last one I have made. It's config, copy in the new folder. Put it over there. Copy the name of the file. And on the right side you can see my Excel sheet. And I keep track of the numbers of the models I make. It's very important if you have a lot of content. And now we can see the number I have to use. Let's open the config. I have to change this number 3 to 4. It's very important for FBX to use trains build 4.5. Username, this is the new username. This is my trains author name. I have to change this name. Very important to use .trainsmesh. It's just for importing FBX files. And just change this name as a description. And I see I have to copy also the thumbnail of the previous object. We can close this one, save. Just copy the thumbnail. Thumbnail, copy, paste. So now we have the config file, the blend file, the FBX file, the texture file, and the thumbnail. Now we can start up Tane. Now I have start up the trains and manage contents for displaying a content manager. And we can now, let's see if it works. You have here on the left side Windows Explorer. We grab the folder and we drag and drop it into Trains. And on the back side of this window, we have this little window. And we can see it has one warning. But as in the wiki from Trains, this warning is not a problem. So everything all is looking good. And we can see in Content Manager our new content. And now we have to open my root and place it into Trains. Let's start up Trains. This is my root. Edit the session. We already on this location. I have put the objects on my root layer. We go to the objects tab. We go to the bottom. If you don't restart Train, all the new objects are on the bottom of the scroll list here. Now we can add the object. And we can see that it seems not to be good, but I have a solution for that. Let's close down. But we have to do one more thing. In Content Manager, select your object, right mouse button, open, show in Explorer. And then we have to change something. It's a little document. Is the .texture file. Content Manager has made this file, and we have to adjust it. Now we can see this line here, alpha. So Trains uses the texture, and is it use also the texture as an alpha layer, so it looks very awful in Trains. Dus we have to delete it. And tile, we can put it ST over here, then close it, save, close the window, still select it, Control M. We have to select it. And we have to submit the edits. And now I have a look. Open the roots. Go to the objects. Now we can see it has to be. I forgot to put it on the root layer. And place the object, and now you can see I have deleted the alpha layer in the .texture file, so you can see everything is now good. If you go inside the building, you can see it's all one-sided faces, so everything is good. And this is how I make most of my objects. Of course, this is a very very simple object, and this is a tram route, so you can only see this front side of the flat. This the back side is not important. Just duplicate the front and the back, so if you look farther away, you can not have a hole in your flat. So thank you for watching this tutorial, and if you have questions, put it in the comments.